More police arrive at the Super 8 Motel after getting a call from a father concerned about his 17-year-old son.
He's either here for narcotics or prostitution for narcotics.
Kids prostituting himself?
Yeah.
That's strong.
The officers smell weed coming from the motel room.
Smells like some hydro in there.
And start knocking on the door.
Let's go open up the door so we can talk to you.
The people inside say they need to get dressed first.
What we are worried about is you having a juvenile in there.
After several minutes, they open the door.
Show me your hands. Okay.
You can't see or hear the teenager on any of the videos.
The only redactions that were made are just to redact the juvenile so that there's no identifying him.
Ralph Shortey stays inside the room, sitting on the edge of one of the unmade beds.
Ralph what? Shorty. You got an ID, Shorty? Shorty doesn't sound like a last name to me.
The officers at that time had no idea, you know, who Mr. Shorty was or anything or the magnitude of what this would turn out to be.
They're just trying to figure out why Shorty's in this motel room with a teenager.
So what was going on over here tonight, man?
We're just hanging out and talking about life and stuff.
The police go through Shorty's backpack and ask him a few more questions before leaving.
Yeah, you can shut the door. You're good. We're done. He probably explained. I don't know if he explained to you. We're just going to do a report, document everything.
Sparking an investigation that ultimately led to Shorty's arrest, resignation from the state Senate, and guilty plea to sex trafficking.